Thanks. I'll start off with the surfing bit and get that out of the way. So I'll just press this. Is there any chance we can dim the lights? For just for the thing? It doesn't matter, but it might look a bit better.
Shadows settle on the place that you left. Our minds are troubled by the emptiness. Destroy the middle, it's a waste of time. From the perfect start to the finish line. And if you're still breathing, you're the lucky ones. 'Cause most of us are heaving through corrupted lungs, setting fire to our insides for fun, collecting names of the lovers that went wrong, the lovers that went wrong.
This is the scary bit here for me. Yeah, that's where I'm all calm and collective, so forgive me if I'm not up here. I want to thank David and Claire and Naomi and Lisa and everyone who's put this on and everyone who's here, because I was here before and it was a privilege to be there then, and then to be asked to actually come and speak is a total you know, complete honor. And I'm gonna do, this is scary as I said, but just to make it even scarier, I'm gonna do something I've never done before. I'm not, definitely not a singer or anything, but I'm just gonna do a bit of a chant to all you guys, just to kind of thank you for, yeah, just for being here and everything. So if you wanna join in, I'll only do it 3 times. And if you wanna close your eyes or whatever you wanna do, but I just wanna say it to you guys. May the sun always shine upon you, the love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. May the sun always shine on you, the love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. May the sun always shine upon you, around you, and the pure light within you guide your way on.
So now I've definitely done the scariest thing I've ever done, and now hopefully I'll be able to speak. Yeah, that was to you guys, because it is an inspiration being here and listening to everyone. It's just amazing. So, and I haven't really got any formal speech or anything to tell you or anything. I'm just going to say where I've come from and what I'm about. And so, as Mark was saying, I grew up on an organic farm. My parents, I suppose, are a bit dreamers. My dad's from Wembley originally. My mum's from Belfast. They met and lived in Dublin for a while. My brother was born. Realised they didn't like the city life. My dad was an engineer, and they went on honeymoon to the west of Ireland. So they liked that, and they just said, let's go to the west of Ireland and grow vegetables. No idea how to grow food. They just started doing it, and I'm just so grateful, because it was the best upbringing I could ever had. You know, we had no money, but we had our family and food and a healthy living. So yeah, we grew up with that lifestyle, and to get away from the farm, Dad would go, our whole family would go to Achill Island just to have a break from the farm, and Dad started surfing. Me and my brother gave it a go, and that was probably the worst thing that ever happened to our family, because that's pretty much all we plagued and wanted to do, and we didn't live near the sea, so it was a real, you know, it was a real hurdle always trying to get there, and it was hard, you know, just to go for a surf. So, but that was my dream when I was a kid. I just wanted to surf, and yeah, I did whatever it took, you know. We lived about an hour from good waves, and that was my whole dream. I wanted to just surf, and I did. I ended up somehow making some sort of career out of it and getting paid to go to Tahiti and Australia and all these places, and I was living my dream, and it was kind of surreal, I suppose. And but then I have the background of hard work and, you know, that healthy living, and I was sitting in Tahiti getting paid to surf, having the time of my life, but kind of starting to feel a bit guilty where I was getting paid to just go surfing. And then it was about 3 years ago now, I was in Tahiti, I'd hurt my knee, I was sitting on a couch, you know, kind of watching the whole world, getting a bit mad and a bit depressing at times, and it's like, geez, like, I think of myself as a good guy, but I'm not actually a part of this solution that we should be all trying to have or achieve, and I was just part of the problem, really. I was getting on a plane and I was going for another surf, and I was like, I can't continue this. So a big light bulb moment, and I decided I know exactly what I can do, because I, you know, the problems are so vast and we can get overwhelmed, but it's like, I can grow vegetables, I can do that, I know I can. And a lot of my friends can't do that because they didn't grow up on farms, and I was like, well, at least I can help my friends and the community around me and do that. And I had this massive dream where I was going to start this huge eco farm and, you know, train all these people and have workshops and eco builds and all this kind of stuff going on. And that's what I came home thinking. But that's kind of also too big of an idea. So I kind of have to rethink everything and just start growing vegetables. You know, you can't really talk about it until you've done it. So since then, my professional career has slowed down. I don't go any more planes anymore. I just had to stop because, you know, I can't be doing one thing and then jumping on a plane again. It just, it doesn't feel right. So I gave up all that, and I just try and put trees in the ground and grow vegetables. And it's funny because I've no land. I don't have anything really. I just want to do it. And straight away, with that kind of positive, pure intention, we're now being given land. You know, people are just saying, "Oh, if you want to grow veg, here, take our plot we're not using." So now, after 3 years, we've got to a point where we have a community garden where we have cook-ups once a week, and people, you know, all ages, young and old, everyone from the community, we do this cook-up. And then we have two other plots that we grow all the food. So if you're interested in growing, you come to the field and you work and we grow. And then once a week, we hang out in the community garden. And it's brilliant because it's just it's a community space. And, you know, we don't actually even talk about, you know, what we should do. It's just eating and watching things grow. And naturally, we all talk about, geez, you know, we should all grow more food. And it's so easy. And I've got a bit of free time tomorrow. I'll come in. But it's all, for me, I'm lucky, I'm so privileged that I had that background of farming, and I know how achievable it is to grow food, so I was like, I can do this, but most people never had that, and they don't believe they can do it, so we've just opened up a space that they don't need to commit to a garden from, you know, January till whatever, November. They can just come in 2 hours a day or once a week, whatever, and just hang out, socialize, do a bit of work, but it's not even work because you're just, you know, you're having a good time. You're just working and listening to the birds, and they ask me questions about what we're doing. It's not like they're learning either. It's just like interest, and they say, it's that easy, and I'm like, yeah, it's that easy. And then they're like, oh, what do you want to do out the back of my garden? And then they have all the tips. Then they go and do it. And I don't know. It's not going to change the world overnight or anything, but it's definitely a change. Like, it's something that wasn't there before. There's now food. We have now a cook-up that people eat healthy food, and that to me is kind of just something I had to do it. You know, I was a very lucky person to be able to go and surf and get paid to do it, and this is my little thing to give back. And yeah, we've a few things going on. We've like a website and for the Moy Hill Community Garden, and my own website, and we have actually got this YouTube series totally by chance. YouTube asked, they wanted to follow me surfing for a year, and I did not want to be involved in a YouTube series of just watching myself surf for a year. It's like not my worst nightmare, but just having to say you're cool all the time wasn't really my interest. But I was like, if you're interested in, like, I have loads of surfing footage, but if you're interested in letting us show the gardening side of what we do and the great people, because there's so many great people doing amazing stuff like we've seen, and they don't ever see the light of day. So I was like, I know a lot of these cool people because I'm interested in it. So I'll go and meet them, just have a chat, and we'll capture it and put it along by some surfing footage. If you're interested in that, we'll do it. And they were keen. So we've that going on since January, and it goes, there's 24 clips. So it's hard work, like, you know, one every 2 weeks, but it's so interesting. Like, just people are doing brilliant stuff out there, and it's a chance to get it to people that wouldn't usually see it. So we've that going on as well. And yeah, that's really it. Like, I just, you know, this is cool coming here. This is my holiday, because since January, we've just been every single day. If the waves aren't epic, I'm just working. And people all tell me I'm mad, you know, like, because we're not growing the veg to sell it. It's literally for the community. I think growing food and healthy food is so much more than just the produce, and the money that people pay for food is a joke, so I don't want to get into it. I just think it can inspire a lot more than just, you know, making a few quid for the community garden. I really just think we can do more with it. So at the moment, it's just, if you help out in the garden, your food is taken care of, and anyone who needs it, anyone who deserves it, I'd love to just give it to them, because a lot of people just feel like they can't do it or something. But yeah, so that's basically what we're doing. And if you're ever in Ireland and you want to pop in, you can come and say hello. And I don't know if you want to ask me any questions now, you can. Otherwise, there was some cool quote I found earlier I was going to read, but...
We'll do it at the end.
Well, I found this just by chance on my laptop, and I'm not very good at reading out stuff, but... You may have been telling people that this is the 11th hour. Now you must go back and tell them this is the hour, and there are things to be considered. Where are you living? What are you doing? What are your relationships? Are you in the right relation? Where is your water? It is time to speak your truth, create your community, be good to each other, and do not look outside of yourself for the leader. This could be a good time. There is a river flowing now very fast. It is so great and swift that there are those who will be afraid. They will try and hold on to the shore. They will feel they are being torn apart, and they will suffer greatly. Now the river has its destination. The elders say we must let go of the shore, push off and into the river. Keep our eyes open and our head above water. See who is in there with you and celebrate. At this time in our history, we are to take nothing personally, at least of all ourselves. For the moment that we do, our spiritual growth and journey comes to a halt. Gather yourselves. Banish the word struggle from your attitude and your vocabulary. All that you do now must be done in the sacred manner and in celebration. We are the ones we've been waiting for.